Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Market Forecast, brought to you by Options University. This is Butch Shorak. It's Monday, November 10th, 2014. Been an interesting week in the market, and as we look at it, access to this video is for educational informational purposes only. Nothing contained in this video, website, or promotional material constitutes a promotion, recommendation, solicitation, or offer of any particular investment, security, or transaction. Options University provides educational services that are meant to teach you the risks and rewards of trading stocks and options. We're not a service that tells you what to trade. We're not implying or guaranteeing any profit. And as always, do not trade with money you cannot afford to lose. Taking a look at the overall market, looking at the indexes for the last week, let's take a look at the Dow, the NASDAQ, the S&P 500, Russell 2000, and see exactly what those numbers look like for the week. And looking at that, let's go ahead and take a look, and there we see our changes for the week. We see the Dow up 183 points for the week, percentage change for the week up 1.1%, year-to-date percentage is up 6%. Looking at the NASDAQ, up 1.79%, 1.79 points, basically flat for the week, up 10.9, almost 11% for the year. Looking at the S&P 500, second leader next to the Dow, we see a 13.87 points up for the week, up 0.7%, up almost 10% for the year, as we've had our big comeback from that October 15th low. A little bit of a pullback, or not quite the same moves up coming out of the Russell 2000, as we see it basically flat for the week, and for the year, in positive numbers at least, up 0.8% for the Russell 2000. Let's go and take a look at economic announcements for the week. As last week, we had a bit of a disappointment on Friday when it came to employment numbers. Those employment numbers were expected to come out by around 235,000, came in at 214,000, bit of a disappointment. Payroll growth exceeded the 200,000 mark for the ninth month in a row, but nonetheless, we're in an area where we should be seeing big changes taking place in the economy, but the big businesses are reluctant to step up hiring, so we're not seeing any big changes coming through there. Looking at the week that's coming up, November 10th, absolutely nothing showing in the overall market. No economic announcements of interest. Tuesday, November 11th, slow day as we have a holiday. November 12th, markets and futures certainly still open. Wednesday, November 12th, nothing that interests us at any great move. We don't have anything of great interest until our weekly return on jobless claims coming in at 8:30 on Thursday, November 13th. And finally, the big day of the week takes place on Friday. It may seem some reluctance coming into that particular day, as we see retail sales coming out at 8:30, import and export prices coming out at 8:30, consumer sentiment 9:55, business inventories at 10 o'clock. Definitely the big day for the week as far as economic announcements are concerned. Looking at the SPX for the past week, we see that, we got a continuation of that deep V that we saw, as strong a V as you've seen in the last few years, and it just keeps heading up. Getting a little weak, hitting one of those trend lines that we drew up, may see some consolidation this week, but any kind of a pullback in this market absolutely gives us some kind of move or opportunity to get back in if we've taken any of our profits. And finally, let's take a look at last week and see exactly what it looks like, as we see Monday having a bit of hesitation in the market, and certainly that made sense with the election coming up on Tuesday and lots of economic news coming out. And we saw on Monday the dollar reach highs against the yen, of the highest we've seen in about 7 years. Saw oil slumping below $80 a barrel. In fact, I saw some $77 a barrel coming across. And so we see, after all that news came out, what did we get? Popped right back up. Any kind of a pullback is an opportunity. Here's our 30-day moving average, our 50-day moving average. Actually, the 50 is above the 30 from that big pullback October 15th. 200-day moving average, quite a bit away. As we saw that big slump take place, we saw that big V take place. and saw why we call this the best 6 months of the market, which started with a bang coming off that October 15th low with that long, long tail giving us that signal. We call that a buy signal. With that fact in mind, let's take a look at the Dow. Looks exactly the same as we see the Dow with a big V, even a bigger run. This was our leader for the weekend. It showed us the power taking place in the Dow as it continues on up. Looking at the NASDAQ, all-time, not all-time highs, but certainly highs for our recent run. And again, November 15th turned around and we got that deep V take place and sharp V. A little bit of consolidation earlier out of the NASDAQ this past week than what we saw out of the out of the Dow, as we see the NASDAQ basically consolidated for the entire week, didn't have that pop up that we saw out of the other indexes. Next, taking a look at the Russell 2000, same type of a consolidation taking place as we saw it just moving sideways, showing us very little power out of the Russell 2000, but certainly had a nice move up and followed that deep V, the first one to show us weakness. Looking at the VIX, we see that VIX that back down around that 12, 13. It's not quite at that 11 level that we saw all summer long between 11 and 12, but certainly getting back down, not showing us a great deal of fear in the overall market. Looking at the bonds, bonds have been going sideways, showing us nothing for the week. In fact, if you look at it, that certainly is about as straight a consolidation as you could ever ask for. And the bonds showing no strength this week as it just went sideways. Basically a little bit up for the overall week, but no great moves out of the bond market, which has certainly been one huge bullish market for us as time has gone on. Gold showed us what weakness really is, went down to that 110 mark out of the on the GLD spider, and we see that we had a little pop up on Friday. No big news that really caused that. Looking at the volume for the week, well, we had basically average volume, showing us very little huge volume as we continued into higher highs. Could expect maybe a little bit of a pullback here as we've reached new highs. Remember that first chart I brought up on the SPX showing that trend line, which we are violating at this point. Looking at the financials, XLF, we see leading the market up, showing us great strength there as it just continues its move up and showing us what strength could be all about. Just boom, boom, boom. Financials leading the market up. All right, next, let's take a look at oil, and we see oil showing us this pullback. There was our big dip on Tuesday. And we see oil not showing us any strength whatsoever. Is this an opportunity, or is oil going to crack these numbers and go even lower? That, of course, is your big question, but at some point along the way, we're going to see this oil turn around. Maybe a little premature at this point. With that thought, for those of you that are gold members, stick around. And for those of you that are not, if you'd like to see more free videos, go to www.optionsuniversity.com/freegold. And for with that thought in mind, thanks for being here. This is Market Forecast, brought to you by Options University. This is Butch Shorak. It's Monday, November 10th, 2014. Thank you for being here.